boy. By request, this is some old Miss JB in the kitchen cooking.
Oh, why y'all want me to cook? You know JB's taking over the kitchen.
And look, she got a crescent wrench over here. What you doing with that, boy?
Working on stuff.
What you cooking?
I am making a beef stew. And this part is the secret ingredient. You have to cut it up really small so nobody will know it has turnips in it.
And what you making that beef stew for?
I'm making this beef stew for fuel for the family at church.
How many people is supposed to feed? Come on, boy. You're making one for 40 damn people. And she got about how many pounds of taters is this over here peeled and cubed up?
10 pounds.
10 pounds of taters peeled and cubed up.
It's probably not enough.
Probably not enough. See, I can echo her. Y'all like that echoing effect?
You do that well.
I know. I do that well. So she gonna get finished whacking and chopping on that turnip. And she got other vegetables gotta go in the stew. Oh shit, camera boy was busy getting him a pop. And Miss JB run that on the Whopper Chopper. You know, this is the
turnips.
That's what it was. Chop them up fine so they'll cook quick.
It's on?
Yeah, it's on.
Okay, y'all will have a question. Who wears the pants?
Wait a minute, whoa. We're gonna have to turn because we're in a light.
Okay.
The lights and the limbs. Okay, now, that's better.
All right, y'all wanna know who wears the pants, who cleans the kitchen?
JB.
Up until about 16 years ago, I did all the cooking, all the cleaning, all the everything. JB started watching cooking shows on TV.
Juice Dad.
And he decided he was going to start cooking. Now, ladies out there, your husbands come in and they cook, but they don't clean up. And they don't get dinner ready till 8, 9 o'clock.
They get free by deleting.
That's what they do. That's just how men cook. If you want them to cook, let them do it. Just let them go. If you want to keep any control of your kitchen whatsoever, kick them out.
And don't let JB in your kitchen. Bell pepper's getting all whacked up.
I don't need to go.
There's she whacking up some onions to speed the cooking process up. And she done already, over on the other side, right over there, some bell pepper she done all chop up. Look like she gotta chop up some,
I need a chopping block with JB's picture on it.
Yeah. She done dumped in a whole bag of carrots that was already cleaned and peeled. And she dumped in that,
potatoes and turnips.
And she done made her up, way over there in the background behind that oil thing, some seasoned flour. And she's gonna season that meat and brown it down with in a skillet back there. She's kinda pushed for time, so she gotta get this a-going. She got some stew meat here she done bought, and she's rinsing it before she gonna cook it. Cause you don't never know what the butcher was doing when he was chopping it up. Alright, seasoned flour and meat. She mixing all that up. And she gotta get that started sauteing. Do like I do and throw it against the wall and stuff. Seasoned floured meat is going in there to saute down.
You just want to saute this down, brown it, and then I'm putting it aside in here until I have all of it browned. Okay. Stop it now.
When? Now?
Yeah.
There's a third batch of meat going in. You want your crescent wrench?
No, not yet.
You sure?
Not sure.
We can use it to tweak the pan.
I think you can get hot.
Yeah.
Video?
The camera boy was over here propped up, half asleep, drinking pops.
And then he started telling me how to cook. You need to do it this way. Why don't you do it that way?
Huh? She just put onions in there and bell peppers in that last batch of meat. We had to regroup. That pot started growing and we started putting stuff in it. So we went got
the gumbo pot.
One of them. This is the small gumbo pot. We got a bigger one than that. I believe this is a 28 quart. I got a 32 or 34 quart also. It's bigger. Bigger pot than that. Bouillon cubes. Going in there. Mrs. JV on the teleophone. Not paying attention, boy.